Leon is there, causing trouble. I require chat. Come on, Chad. Come on, Chad, with the shotgun. In order to keep your vehicles in pristine running order, you try to avoid hitting enemies. Right now, I'm kind of trying to dodge them best I can while still keeping an eye open for Chad, who either I missed or is nowhere to be seen. Since I'm here, let's see what's in this maintenance locker. Nails and blades and nails. Okay, not interested. No. You do not grab me. No. Bad zombie. Oh, there's a good health reserve there. But I'm not gonna get to it yet. I thought Chad was close to the pizzeria. Chad moves about, that's his problem. I'm afraid my piece of garbage bike will break soon. Right now I only have access to one bike. If I ever defeat that dude, Leon over here, I get access to his bike, but his bike does not have the chainsaws on it. It's just a standard speed bike. Well, this is a waste. I can't find Chad. Ah, I hear him. There he is. Hiding in a storefront. Ooh-wee, a live one. Ah, okay. I was gonna say get rid of the zombies anyway. Now he's in a choke. Remember, if you don't stop chokes, the survivor will die. Okay, it's good. In the Dead Rising 2 off the record, you have to clear the path for him before he'll follow you. Not just clear the path, destroy all zombies in his vicinity. In this one, all you have to do is talk to Doris, then find him, because he moves about, talk to him, and then all should be alright. I just gotta wait for him. Ideally, what I should do is I should keep him off camera so I could see his little preview window, and make sure he is not being choked, because if he's being choked, then it's no good know-how, and he will most likely perish. Gotta talk. Good. Got both Chad and Doris. Oh my god, he just shot Doris. Point blank. It was an accident, I swear. Okay. Come on, Chad and Doris. I'm bringing you to the exterior safe house. I don't know if that's a wise idea or not, but too late now. My piece of junk bike's gonna blow. I don't know if it was a better idea to bring these guys via inside the malls. Ah, yeah, there's a psychopath. I'm not smart. Okay, here's the Royal Flush anyway. My bike's a smoking mess. If I go in here, I don't think he can bring his bike in here. So I'll wait for him here. Hmm. Chad could care less about doors. Sovekeeper, Chad's here. Doors, where's Doors? Oh, who knows? Good for you, Chad. Do your best, Chad. Shooting good. Don't shoot doors, though. You did that already. That didn't work out too well. Okay, good job. Now, ensuring that the survivors transition with you, of course. Oh, this is a great lookout. Since they're both here and they both have weapons, too bad that psychopath doesn't approach you. If he did, I'd just let them do the dirty work. They have unlimited ammo, by the way, so that helps. Pro tip, when you have a vehicle, clear the front of an entry that you need before entering. Just make sure you enter far away from your vehicle. They both have green indicators on them, so I can progress within the royal flush. I didn't properly consider what other missions I have waiting for me. This I triggered, we know. Once bitten's gotta wait, we know. Cure protester. Okay. I am now going to show you how to make the best easy to make combo weapon in the game. Now, this is extremely important, as I feel, in order to complete the game relatively easy. So what you do, and it's important to note that both of these components are available in the main mall, your main mall, very close to the safe house, actually. First things first, you are going to need a Bowie knife. I already have one. Sometimes you can find zombies carrying them, then you knock it out of their hands. Or you just climb up on yesterday, today, and tomorrow up here, and looky looky. Bowie knife. Very good. Now what we're going to need is we are going to need boxing gloves. Unfortunately, I don't have enough slots for two boxing gloves. But can... Oh, you both have guns. You won't give me anything. Okay, no worries. I'll just make one for now. One pair for now. But you saw, I got the boxing gloves and the mansport, and I got the Bowie knife on top of the yesterday, today, and tomorrow newsstand. In fact, I think I'm going to run back and get another pair of boxing gloves just to make two pair. Actually, I won't need to. Okay. Okay. Behold. Put down the boxing gloves on the workbench, and you put down the Bowie knife. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Knife gloves. As you can see, right now it's just a scratch card, so that means that I won't get double PP, double experience, for the use of... for those kills using those weapons. Now, as you can see, I instructed the couple to wait. And the way I did that was I brought up my targeting reticle, which on computer, PC, is brought up by holding right mouse button, and then pressed the call button as I was holding the targeting reticule, which is Q on PC. Okay, boxing gloves, very good. If you want a high-value food item, there is the orange juice right here. High value. I recommend you take it. Okay. Moving on. They should still be waiting for me. I assume they're safe. For the most part, the maintenance hallway, the maintenance closet hallway, leading to the safe house, is a safe zone. Generally, zombies don't come in here. They do at times, but... unless you're at the second stage where the very, very aggressive zombies are present. In which case, they, on the other hand, will venture everywhere. In fact, there's sometimes two located right in this opening area for ventilation, so you gotta be careful, especially when you have survivors in tow. Doors isn't clear. Doors is now clear. Cha-ching. Level up. Yeah, health increase. New skill move. Very good. That calls for a save. You compare all three. I usually do it by level, and then if two have the same level, then I work by PP. The one with the lowest PP gets overwritten. Remember to always use all three save slots in order to stagger your saves in case you make a mistake with timers or what have you and you end up with a game that you cannot progress in. It helps. Once bitten, can't do it yet. Chucked a role model, I have time. Ticket to ride. Investigate the underground. You know what? I think I'm going to cut out here and I think I'm going to go gamble. I'm going to go gamble and from there I'm going to progress with either probably locate the cure protester because his meter will probably go down quicker than will the case 2-2, I assume. Once again, I'm making an assumption that case 2-2 ticket to ride I can perform said barn burner and it's low already. I didn't need that. Save the trap, people. Barn burner. Only needs 10%, according to my previous guide. So, I think I'm still gonna gamble. Still gonna be greedy about this, and still gonna gamble. Yeah, that seems fun to me. It's gambling time. So, gonna progress to my slot machine. Have two pairs of knife gloves, so this is ample in order to defend me. I mean, I defend myself with those terrible pedestal support stands, so. I hear the hoods, the punks, whatever you want to call them. The looters. Generally in Dead Rising 2 regular, unlike Off the Record, they won't just come out into the open and pursue you. They will instead stay in their store, their specific store, and if you enter their store, then they'll engage you. Hey now. Waiting for it to load. Slot Ranch Casino. Perform my ritual. Read my magazines. Magazine 1. Magazine 2. Magazine 3. Is that necessary? Who knows? I do it as a good luck charm. Not bothering to engage these zombies yet. If they come to me, then I'll engage them at the machine. Before, I used to try to clear out the entire area before I gamble. Now I kind of gamble and clear at the same time. Make myself a little hole to work out of, and bet max. Remember, there's two betting buttons. You don't want to bet minimum, you want to bet max, which is the rightmost button. Because it pays out the most. Of course, this requires good amount of cash to start